The Upanishad series, Moujud, is the inner guide. When for the first time center speaks to you, you are bound to be in a great turmoil, chaos, because something like this never happened. And then all that was settled begins to unsettle. All that was established will not be established anymore. You had felt a certain kind of security that will not be there anymore. You are feeling as if do not know what is happening. All that you was feeling secure in is no longer secure, and all that you were feeling as meaningful is no longer meaningful now. Everything will go topsy-turvy because the center has a totally different approach towards reality than the circumference. Both have a different methodology. The center lives in unknown and unknowable realm. Circumference remains in the known. When your journey of love begins, life is love. When it begins, it is because of desires, passion. You enter into a love relation. Center has spoken to you. If by the time you attain the age of 40, if meditation has not been blended to love, the flower of love will not blossom. Instead, there will be jealousy and hatred naturally born. And if love and meditation have blended together, the flowers of love will begin to appear. And the flower of love is compassion. Compassion is the flower that grows on the tree of consciousness, of which love is one of the branches. So then it happens, you leave the unknown and unknowable and you return to the known. Every time when there is a failure in love, we return to the known. This is how the circumference goes. When circumference finds that it has failed in achieving what it wanted, it returns to the known. Known means the friends and family. In the beginning, when your journey of love was to begin, center has spoken to you. You did not listen to anyone. You went on according to your inner voice and you defied everything. But then along the journey, the flower has not blossomed because meditation was not added, and meditation was the missing dimension in life. The flower did not blossom, the soil get barren. the energies begin to dilapidate. There is a failure, you return to the moon. Circumference always relates to the known, and center relates to the unknown. When the center speaks to the circumference, there has to be a great turmoil. Everything will go topsy-turvy because center has a totally different approach towards reality, towards life than the circumference. When depth speaks to the surface, there is bound to be trepidation. So when it happened to Moujud, he went to his superior in trepidation and said that he had to leave. You remember this story. One day Moujud was walking in the garden of a building near his house. He met Khidr, dressed in shimmering green, and told him to leave your job, to leave his job and meet him in 3 days' time. So, when the inner voice communicated to him, he went to his superior and told him that he had to leave. But there is no way. If you are a man of presence, if you are a meditative person, the center speaks to you. Khidr appears. Khidr means your inner guide. When Khidr appears and says to you, now do this, you are a man of presence, you have to do it. Even in spite of yourself, even against yourself, and you know many of the people who come to the meditation, sometimes they do not have a choice, they just come because of the inner voice. There are people, particularly Indian, who say satsang is enough. We just want to be in your presence. Why should we do meditation? They do not understand. They cannot be in my presence because they are not present as yet. They are not Moujud. Moujud means one who is present to the moment. You come to the company of the master. Master becomes your inner voice. But you do not understand it. And trust is not born. They cannot be in my presence. The physical presence is meaningless because they are not yet present. Just sitting by the side is not really satsang because you think 1001 thoughts sitting by my side. You can be physically here, but you may not be psychologically here at all. You can be anywhere in the world. You can be on some other planet. But that is not satsang, that is not communion. You can be anywhere and you are in the company of the master, then time and space does not matter. Unless you are present, not only physically but psychologically too, unless your whole presence surrounds me, unless you are really here in this moment, connected, plugged, only then there is a communion or satsang, not before that. But for that, to happen. You have to go through meditation. And people are lazy. They would like God as a gift without even trying to become worthy of receiving it. So Moujud told his superior that he had to leave. Everyone in the town soon heard of this and they said, poor Moujud, he had gone mad. That is what always happens about a meditator. Remember it. It will be said that you too. It has to be said about you. It must have been said already, poor Moujud. They said he has gone mad because everyone in the world thinks he is sane. What he thinks is right. And then he cannot find a solution to his problems. They cannot believe why one should meditate and for what. They constantly go on asking the person who meditates, please, what are you getting into it and for what? Some say that I am meditating to get more relaxed, to get my problems solved. No, meditation has nothing to do with these things. Why are you wasting your time sitting silently and gazing your navel or things like these? Do not waste time. Time is money. How can you do things? How can have more? How can possess more? Do not waste time. Gone cannot be recovered. And what are you doing sitting silently with your eyes closed? Open your eyes and compete in the world. This world is a struggle for survival. Those who sit silently and meditate will be lost. The only way to attain anything is to fight, be aggressive, and not be passive. This is how you think. This is how circumference thinks. Remember, there are two modes of life. The action mode, the other is non-action. The action mode believes in action and non-action mode believes in receptivity, being a receptive. Meditation comes in the category of non-action mode. What Chinese call the we, wu, we means action without action, action through inaction. This is the entire teaching of Bhagavad Gita, doing without doing at all. Meditation is an inaction mode. The world is full of people who live in one mode, the action mode. And man who lives in action mode cannot understand what is going on in the person who has entered into non-action mode. You cannot understand this at all. Now Moujud is entering into non-action mode. Whenever center speaks to you, you must go, you must trust. You have to enter into non-action mode. Then things happen around you. You do not have to make an effort. Your effort is that you have a clear perception that center has spoken to you. You are sincere about it, you trust it. And there is self-discipline, then things begin to happen naturally and spontaneously. Then the entire existence comes to support you in myriad ways. This is not your doing. This is because of the non-doing. This is the way of the inner. He has seen the world. He has acted for many. He has done many things, and now he knows that if he goes on doing those things, he will end up as in the highest position, may become the supervisor of weights and measures, or reach to the highest position in his job. But what is beyond that? That has no longer remained any appeal for him. He wanted to see. He wants to be. He wants to know that which is. Before death knocks down, he wants to know something of the deathless. He risks his life. People are bound to think that he has gone mad. But as there are many candidates for the job, they soon forgot about Moujud. And that is how it happens. If you enter into the realm of meditation, for a few days people think that you are mad, and then they forget all about you. They have 1001 things to think about. They cannot go on thinking about you. They take it for granted that you are mad. So you are mad, and now what is the point of thinking about you again and again? If you renounce, if you escape, if you start moving into the non-action mode, for a few days they will think about it, and all things will disappear, because there are always too many candidates to replace you. When you die, immediately your place is filled. Sometimes the people who are very influential, they think when they die, the world will miss them. How long does a world miss you? How long does that void remains? A simple experiment you can do. You can take a bucket full of water. Make a fist of your hand. Immerse it into the bucket of water. Then pull it out. There will be a hole. And as soon as you pull it out, the water from all sides will start rushing to fill it. How long does that hole remain? For that long you will be missed. You die, your house will be filled by somebody else. You leave the job, your post will be filled by someone else. Your bank balance will be in somebody else's name. They are just waiting. In fact, they are getting worried. Why are you staying for so long? So on the appointed day, Moujud met Khidr, who said to him, "Tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream. Perhaps someone will save you." These words are of great significance. Khidr says, "Tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream." That is what the master goes on saying to you. Many are told, only a few listen. Many are called, only a few come. Now, for no reason at all, Moujud comes and Khidr simply says this: tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream. Normally, when people come to a master, they do not come with a conscious desire, because it is the unconscious that speaks to him. All the journey begins through the unconscious. The unconscious desire is always there. Otherwise, you would not come to the master. But later on, when one realizes what has happened, that you have become a seeker, you have known much about the world, you were a money expert or something else, then the problem comes in. You were an intelligent, soon you will understand that it was not that what you wanted. Remember, a master on the outside is nothing but the reflection of his room. Master on the outside is nothing else but the reflection of his room. You cannot understand your own inner guide. Hence, the master on the outside is needed. And you cannot understand your own inner guide because you do not know that language. You are completely unacquainted with those words, those symbols, those metaphors, those whispers, those sounds. You are completely unaware of how the inner guide conveys its message to you. The outer master is just a screen on which you project your inner guide. And the outer master helps you to understand your inner master. When you have understood the inner master perfectly, then the outer master says, if you meet me on the way, kill me. Then the master is no more needed. When flower has blossomed, then the master is not needed. You are completely unaware of how inner guide conveys its message to you. Therefore, the outer master is just a screen on which to project your inner guide. And the outer master helps you to understand your inner master, your innerness. And when you have understood this perfectly, you don't need the master. Now Khidr is saying to him, without even introducing him, what is going to happen. Just abruptly he says, tear away your clothes and throw yourself in the stream. Without even motivating him about what is going to happen, about why should he tear his clothes and throw himself into the stream? Khidr has not explained anything like this. Abruptly he says, tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream. But why? There is no why. If you live with a master, there is no why. Only then you are with a master. Otherwise, you can be physically, but you are not really with the master. Your physical presence cannot bring about any transformation. Tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream. And not only that, he says, perhaps, uses the word perhaps, someone will save you. He does not say it with certitude that you will be saved. Tear your clothes and throw yourself into the stream. Perhaps someone will save you. There is no guarantee either. He is not giving you any guarantee that if you follow this, this will happen. The master always speaks in that language of perhaps. Because if the master says it is guaranteed, then you will not need trust. For trust to happen, he uses the word perhaps. Then the guarantee will function as your trust. You will trust the guarantee. You will not trust the mysterious life and its mysterious processes. The master always says perhaps. People come to me and ask, if they become seeker, will they be able to attain enlightenment? What can be the answer? Perhaps. Perhaps not. Who knows? The master has to use the word perhaps. He has to give you the feeling of perhaps, because only then you will be able to risk yourself. If it is guaranteed, 100% guarantee, then there is no risk. And where is the need for the trust? Nothing can be guaranteed. All remains open. That is why only those who are courageous, who have guts, enter the path, enter into meditation, enter on the spiritual path. Moujud did so. Even though he wondered if he was mad, yet still he entered, he listened to his inner voice. And remember, when you listen to the inner voice and circumference comes and says, how can you trust that? But you have to defy all that and continue to listen to the inner voice. I give you an example. Life, these moments keeps on coming again and again. For the sake of my son to continue his life, I am trying to build some apartments so that he can get the work in his field. I have no money. Where does it come from? I don't know either. All I know, all that is needed is always fulfilled. I was going through doing my regular livelihood work, which I do by marketing the East Indian food items in the country. I went to deliver certain items in a marketplace. A man was sitting there, he called me, he said, Swami, come, I have to tell you something. I said, what? He said that I will give you a place to open a store rent-free. Center has spoken to you, you doubt. Why is this man giving you free? Whether he is really giving you free or what? I need the money to complete the project. Where am I going to get it from? Because of my clear vision, certitude that the assistance will come in myriad ways. Always remember, when you have a clear vision, you are sincere about it, you are disciplined, listening to the center, the support comes from many ways. Then a doubt comes in whether he is really going to give you or not. Immediately I have to listen to the center. If center has spoken, I should listen to the center, risk everything and see what happens. Do not mix the center and circumference ever. Do not mix the center and circumference ever. If you are listening to the center, go on listening to the center and do not bother what it is happening. Whatsoever happens when you listen to the center will be for your transformation. And when you are transformed, it is the responsibility of the existence to take care of your needs. You are in a non-action mode. I do not do things, instant things happen around me, whether it is for my living or otherwise. But such thoughts are natural. One who trusts, one who loves, goes in spite of all this, but the mind goes on following and chasing you like stray dogs. The nature of the mind is like a stray dogs. They keep on following you wherever you go. They go on barking, but slowly and slowly, if you do not pay much attention to it and you go on your errand, those dogs are left far behind. Their barking becomes more and more distant and distant and distant, and one day suddenly you are alone. The mind is no more there. That day is a day of great joy. Moujud did so. Even though he wondered if he was mad, who will not wonder? That's what I gave you an example. The center spoke to me. Where this person came all of a sudden suddenly, he gives me, then I ask him, I said, are you really giving me the place free of rent? He said, in the beginning, which is natural, when you start making the money, you will give me the rent. Understood very clearly, gives you an opportunity. It is the existence, it is the center that has spoken. It is my non-action mode that my job is to take care of the people who come to me, who listen to my posts on, read them on a day-to-day basis. That is my work. But that does not earn any money. So I have to make my living. And Sufis have always made their living and continued the work of transformation of human consciousness. They do not depend on the income coming from like any other priest and so. So following that tradition, I continue to make my living like an ordinary person, anybody else. But you remember that I am in a non-action mode. Things happen around me. And if you are in a non-action mode, you will realize that in a mysterious way, things happen around you. You were not expecting and it happened suddenly. Who will not wonder? This looks so absurd. He may have gone mad. They are thinking that Khidr might give him a glimpse of God or might give him a key to open the door of mystery or might show him the hidden treasures of or something. And now here this man says, tear your clothes and throw yourself in the stream. And on top of that he says, perhaps, not even certitude, gives a confidence, says perhaps someone will save you, that is all. But he did. Remember, If when I say to you, jump into the stream, I know it is natural, the mind will resist. But if you can do it, only then something is possible. It happened during the Mughal period, when Shah Jahan was the emperor of the Mughal Empire. He carried his children, Dara Shikoh, Aurangzeb and the others, to his master, Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Masoom Razi Allah Ta'ala Unhu in Sarhind. And he asked, Hazrat, tell me which of my son will become the next emperor. So Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Masoom was sitting on a place that is where the master was being a sheen, was sitting. He got up from the seat and asked the eldest son of Shah Jahan to sit down. Dara Shikoh said, how can I? He was the most religious person, concerned and interested in Upanishads. He has gotten many of the Upanishads translated, the Hindu scriptures translated into Persian. How can I sit down on a place which is meant for you? He said, no, he cannot be the king. Then he asked the other, similar happened when came the turn of Aurangzeb. We know him as a treacherous king in Indian history. But that is one aspect of him. The other aspect that I know, the master got up, Hazrat Khwaja Muhammad Masoom, and he said, Bin Ashim, sit down. He read a couplet. He says, if your master says to dip your janamaz, the prayer mat into wine, do so, because he knows what is haq, what is truth, what is the way. If you are ready to dip your janamaz into wine because the master has said, then something can happen. Otherwise, do not waste your time around the master. And this is what Khidr did. Perhaps someone may save you. I know it is natural the mind will follow you like a stray dog, resist, but if you can do it, only then something is possible. Since Moujud could swim, he did not drown, but he drifted a long way before a fisherman hauled him into his boat, saying, O foolish man, the current is strong. What are you trying to do? Since he could swim, I know that if you jump into the stream, you will be able to swim. Because swimming is a natural phenomenon. In life, when the problem comes in, you know how to adjust to the circumstances and situations. This is the way of swimming. One need not learn it. I am not talking about the outer stream and the inner stream. There you may be drowned. But I am talking about the stream of the inner consciousness. The stream of consciousness, if you jump into it, and that is what is meant. That is the parallel story that you have to decode. You naturally know. Have you ever seen any fish learning to swim? I have heard. Once Mullah Nasruddin was caught because he was fishing at a place where fishing was prohibited. And the inspector came suddenly and he caught Mullah red-handed. He was just taking out the fish. He immediately dropped the fish back and sat there undisturbed. The inspector was standing there. He asked, "What are you doing, Mullah?" He said, Mullah responded, "I am teaching this fish to swim." Now, no fish needs to be taught swimming. Fish is born there. Fish swimming is like the breathing. Who taught you breathing? And there is no need to be afraid. If you are ready to trust, to jump into the stream of your consciousness, you will know how to swim. At the most, it can happen that you may be drifted a long way before the fisherman holds you up. You can at the most drift, that is all. You cannot be drowned once you trust the existence. You can never be drowned. You belong to consciousness. You are part of that stream, the cosmic stream that is consciousness. The fisherman said, "Oh, foolish man, the current is strong. What are you trying to do?" Just see the beauty of the answer. And he really does not know what he is doing, because he has not been told for what he is jumping in the river. He had not even asked his, "Why should I jump into the stream?" Here the seekers come. They want to know why I should do it. And if they are asked something to do which is against their morality, against their wish, they drift. And why should I tear through my clothes? What is the purpose of it all? He had not asked about anything, not the purpose. And this is what is trust. That is going into the unknown. I talk about continuously, that is an adventure. That is an unclinging mind, that is courage. Moujud said, when the fisherman asked, "What are you trying to do?" Moujud said, "I really do not know." And he is true, he does not know. If you know, then you do something. It is not courage. If you know and then do, it is not trust. You are trusting your knowledge. There are two kinds of seeker. One who has jumped into the river when the master says to him or her, "Jump." The other who thinks, broods, contemplates for and against, and then one day decides. That decision is coming out of his mind. That decision will be based on his own past, on his own conditionings. But that will not be able to take him far. I will have to work hard on him because he had missed the first opportunity. People go on missing the opportunity on a day-to-day basis. I will have to work hard on him because he has missed the first opportunity that was provided for him, and the person clings to the ego. The first opportunity was there. The things would have been immensely simple if he had simply taken a jump. To come to the master is like taking a jump into the river of consciousness, into the stream, you throw it. You do not know what is going to happen. Why did I come to the company of the master? I do not know. What is going to happen? I do not know. There are those type of people. The vast majority is of those who are mind oriented. My work consists with those who simply are ready to take a jump. A little call, yes, I am ready. Who do not have asked why, who have simply looked into the eyes, who simply look into the eyes of the master and felt a mad desire, a mad longing to be with the master, to go with the master without knowing what is going to happen, to go to the end. The fisherman said to him, "You are mad, but I will take you into my reed hut by the riverside yonder, and we shall see what can be done for you." When he discovered that Moujud was well spoken, he learned from him to read and write, and in exchange Moujud was given food, and he helped the fisherman with his work. After a few months, he was trying to settle. Khidr again appeared. And just observe how it is, the intricacy of this story. First time he appeared while Moujud was walking in the garden of a building near his house. Now Moujud is resting on the bed and Khidr appears at the foot of Moujud's bed and said, "Get up now, leave this fisherman, you will be provided for." First he said, "Perhaps someone may save you," but now he says, "You will be provided for." The word "perhaps" is gone. Because you have taken the first step, you will be provided for. Now things are changing. Trust is growing. And even the inner guide is showing the respect for the trust that is growing. The time he appeared at the foot of Moujud's bed, this is showing respect. Now Moujud is not an ordinary man anymore. The trust that he has shown in the first place without a questioning mind has transformed him. He is a courageous man, heroic, brave. Without asking any why, he knows how to love. He knows how to penetrate into the future without carrying the load of the past. The inner guide shows the respect and appears at the foot of his bed. Khidr said, "Get up now and leave this fisherman." It is the middle of the night. Things have settled now. The fisherman was very happy with Moujud. Whenever you are settling, the inner guide will unsettle you again. Whenever you are settling, the master will unsettle you again. When people come and they start doing the meditation, things beginning to settle, and master does something, that things become unsettled, you get disturbed. Because you are not to be allowed to settle anywhere before God. Before that final merger happens, many moments come when you think that you have reached the ultimate, but no. You are on the voyage, you stay overnight in many places, but that is not the resting point. You may rest for an hour or so, and then you have to continue your journey. But you like the ambience of that place, that state, and you want to settle there permanently. Your journey does not end until you reach the final. The journey of the seed continues until it becomes a flower. You can have an overnight stay, but by the morning you have to leave. In the middle of the night, Khidr says, get up and leave this fisherman. And it is always now with the master. It is never tomorrow. It would have been easier and more compassionate to tell him, you can rest right now, but tomorrow morning you leave. But it is always when master speaks, it is now. For a master, the only time that exists is now. And the only space that exists is here. So it is the dimension of here now. It is the dimension of here now. You will be provided.